Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji and this video is created for the George Brown College ARC 3015. So far we created a grid in Dynamo, now we're gonna add some circles, and if we wanna follow the algorithm here, we are on step 4 now. We're gonna create some circles and then we're gonna randomize the radius of the circles to have a pattern like this. I need to remind you to save your Dynamo file by going to File, Save, and this is going to be R3015 week 2. And it's giving me a grid. Notice that the file is saved as .dyn, which stands for Dynamo, and it's a different file than your Revit file. And that makes sense because the idea of Dynamo is that you want to use it for different projects. So that's why the Dynamo file is being saved separately than Revit file. And notice that the next time you open your Revit file, if you have not imported the geometry from Dynamo into Revit, you need to open your Dynamo file as well. So I'm going to save it. Another point I want to mention is that, as you noticed, if I change these items here, my geometry changes simultaneously. Now, this is a simple script for now. It's not very complicated. If it's too complicated, because it's working synchronous and simultaneously, it might just stop working, right? In that case, if you have a complicated set of scripts, it's a good idea to change this to manual, right? Now, if I change something, it does not automatically change, but I have to click run. Okay, now the possibility for the system to crash is a bit lower. Okay, so let's go to the geometry, curves. The circles are here, or you can just type circle. How about we use the circle by center point and radius? I want to go with by center point, radius, and normal, and I'm going to talk about normal later. Okay? So as we talked about, the grid is going to be the center points of the circles. I'm going to connect the point to center point. And you remember this is on manual, so I need to run it. You see the radius is on 1 by default. We can use a different number slider to assign to the radius, or just assign some number manually in here. And now, I want to create a number slider, so I'm going to go with number slider, or you can copy and paste one of the number sliders on the screen. Maybe I want it to go only from 0 to 2, and the sub is 0.1. Okay? I can connect this to the radius. And if I make it smaller, I'm gonna have a set of circles here. I want to rename this node to be the radius, or the circle radius. And next and last step would be to randomize the radius. Now for that, we need to go to the math functions here, or you can just type randomize. Now, if you go to math, it's part of the functions actually. And let me do this. I need the random list because I have a list, right? So I'm gonna use the math random list. So this is going to randomize a list. So I also need to create a list. If I go back to input or to list and bring a list create item in here, let me attach this output to this input. Also, I want to pin these items here so you can see. For now, it says null, which means it's just empty, right? So if I attach some number slider here again, so I'm gonna bring a number slider and maybe this could be also integers, so I'll go with one for the step, and I'm gonna attach this to the item. And remember that this is a manual, so whatever you do, you need to run it. I'm gonna change this back to automatic. I wanna put this maybe on one. Okay, now I have one number here, which is randomly generated, and it's between 0 and 1. You see that number is 0.0437 and so on. That's gonna be our radius, okay? A randomized list always creates a random number between 0 and 1. If you want to have a larger number, we can do some more math functions to do that. Okay, so what I want to do is that I want to get rid of this radius option here, and that randomized number is going to be assigned to the radius. Now, you see, if I make this number a bit larger, it starts to create more circles here. Okay, why is it only 6 in here? Because I have assigned 6. As you see, it's considering this row as one list, list number 0, and now there are 6 items inside that. But I have like 8 items inside that because I have assigned 8 to the amount on the Y series. So if I change this to 8, now I have 8 numbers here. If I increase this number, you see while I have different numbers in here, it only assigns all of them sealed to the first row. Now the way to address this is by creating more items here actually. So if I have 6 items on X direction, which comes from there, I need to have 6 items under the list create. So going from 0 to 5. And I need to assign some value to all 6 of them, and it's gonna generate that for me. And if I change these values in here, the shape of those random numbers change each time. So the pattern actually changes each time, right? Now you see they're a little bit inside each other. If we want to avoid that, we can either multiply the radius by some number, or another thing we can do is to change the step size in here. So if you remember, the X and Y Z of the points are one unit away from each other. So if I bring another number slider and put it here, and let's say it's between 0 and 5, I don't need more than that, and I want to connect this two step size of both sequence nodes on X and Y directions. Notice that you can go with different numbers for X and Y, that's up to you. If I change this to, let's say, 2, now they're gonna be a little bit away from each other. Let me go to this view and move this a little bit to the corner here, and go back to this one. Okay, so now Each point is 2 units away on both x and y direction, and now they are not intersecting each other anymore. You can change these values here to come with different patterns and then go with the one that you like, right? The only thing that you need to pay attention here is that this number should not be less than 8 here, and that it comes from here. If that happens, some of the radius would be 0. It should be either 8 or more. In the next video, I'm going to show you how you can export the geometries back to Revit, actually, because in Revit you cannot select this at the moment. You see that? It's just actually a ghost of the circles. It's not an object yet. So I'm going to show you how you can export them from Dynamo into Revit and how you can assign material to them in Revit.